What is up, YouTube? Looking a little different in this video. Shaved the old beard there. And it kind of made me laugh because it's funny how different I look. Anyway, today I'm going to be reviewing Abercrombie and Fitch First Instinct Blue. I heard a lot of good reviews about this. So let's just get right on into it. As you can see, it says on the side here, Abercrombie and Fitch First Instinct Blue. It doesn't say blue on the front, it only really says it on the side here. So it's that's what it is. All right. So the bottle itself is pretty interesting. It feels like it's not flat, you know, there's a kind of a wavy pattern, kind of almost mimicking a wave, I guess, a calm wave there. That's kind of cool. This is a 3.4 ounce. It's an eau de toilette, and let's get right into it. Can't smell anything off the atomizer here, so it's going to be a fresh test here, and I guess it didn't even really matter where I twisted it because both sides here are kind of the same. So yeah, let's give it a spray here. Weave it around a little bit and get a scent here. Not bad, not bad. This kind of reminds me of something here. It kind of almost reminds me of the Merry Time from Tommy Bahama. Yeah, if I was to compare it to something, I would compare it to that. The original one, though. Yeah. It's kind of like that one, but lighter in scent. Not bad. It's really fresh, clean. Not really soapy, but it does have a very clean note to it. It's really refreshing and aquatic. I mean, this is really, really aquatic here. You know, there is a little bit of a woodsy note in here. Man, this is very nice. I can see why it gets complimented. This would make a really good gym fragrance. Really clean and masculine. But yeah, it does remind me a lot of that Tommy Bahama Merry Time. That is kind of weird. Because I have that one. And I love that one, by the way. So I love this one as well. I feel like this one is a little more on the spicier side, though. There may be some sort of cardamom in here, maybe. Really good. Yeah, it is very aquatic, but it is very citrusy, woody, aromatic. You know, there are a lot of spices in here. I would say it's like a fresh spice, warm spice, which kind of, you know, takes it a little bit away from that, the Merry Time there. But man, this is actually very nice. It's very, sweet. I don't know. It's almost like a fruity sweet or like a ambery sweet. It's very good. Man, all of these notes are just really well together. You know, those are the ones that I kind of go for, you know, the citrusy, woody, fresh, spicy, all of that is in here. Yeah, that is very, very good. If I were to rate it, I would have to give this a 9 out of 10. You know, it may change later, depending on the longevity. I'm not sure how long that'll, you know, last. I'll have to update you guys on it. But, yeah, very masculine, and I can tell there's lavender in here. There's a definite lavender note that I personally love. I think it kind of gives it almost like an herbal kind of smell to it. Herbal, powdery. But this isn't really powdery. This is more fresh, clean, vibrant, very fresh, spicy, woody, citrusy, aromatic, aquatic. I mean, this is a lot of things. And possibly ozonic as well. It's got a light nature to it. Almost like an airy aquatic. I do like this a lot, personally. In terms of scent, I'd give it a 9 out of 10. I'm not really sure about longevity, though, yet. But yeah, this smells very good. Super fresh and clean. Wasn't too expensive. It was pretty decent. Would I suggest you buying it? Yeah. Yeah, I would. And I'm giving it 9 out of 10. Thank you all for watching, liking, sharing, and subscribing, doing all that stuff. And I will see you all in the next one. Peace.